The Voices of Kentuckiana, hosted by Debbie Crawford. Music by Clay Beverly. Produced by Lynn King.
Everybody, we are here in Fireman's Park down on Vaughn Drive in Madison, Indiana, and we're going to talk to Greg Ziesmer. He's actually the coordinator for the Riverfest Festival down here, and it is just got some lineups, doesn't it? You got some real hitters.
Got some good stuff. It's River Roots Music and Folk Arts Festival. Again,
yes.
This year, this is our 10th anniversary, our 11th show. This is my 6th show, and we're really excited about this opportunity, you know, doing... We've finally created a legacy. You know, we've actually have a history that people talk about.
Yes, you
now.
Have.
And it's really grown a lot, especially in the past 5 and 6 years, not just due to my efforts, but due to the entire efforts of the committee, the change of vision that we chose to take a different course with the festival,
now,
and it's really paid off.
How many bands do you have now compared to 6 years ago?
6 years ago, we had one stage, and we had 3 bands on Friday night and 5 bands on Saturday. So we had 8 total. This year, we have 17 bands.
Oh, my gosh.
On Thursday, Friday, and Saturday.
That's all the music you can say.
So, yeah, we've doubled our deal. You know, it's amazing. And our patrons wanted this. They talked to us about, hey, you know, it'd be great if you guys could have a second stage and have music going all the time. And so it was like, oh, well, sure, we can do that.
Right.
And so we did. And this is our 4th year of having the River stage. And last year we had some rain, but we always have plenty of tented areas at the festival. So there's no need for people to be discouraged by weather to come to this festival.
But this year it seems to be dry.
Oh, it's been great. Yeah, the river hasn't come over
warm?
Its banks.
No.
And, you know, it's been a nice dry, you know, really wonderful spring, and that always bodes well for River Roots. That means we're going to have a really good show, and people should go ahead online to riverroots.org now and plan ahead, buy your tickets, reserve your campsites, reserve your hotel rooms, because they're filling up fast. You know, we're only a month away now.
Right. Now, their campsites actually are here at Fireman's Park.
Right here. Yeah, Fireman's Park.
Right here where we are now, and then also over here next to us at the... Regatta building.
Right behind the Regatta
area behind it. And then Mumbles has a grassy area behind it, and that's also camping. So you have a large area for people to camp in with tents.
Anybody can bring it. You can bring a tent. There's a maximum of 4 people per site.
Yes.
And it's only $10 a night.
Oh, my goodness.
For camping. And kids 12 and under are free to the festival and also free in the campgrounds. I mean, we want to make this a family. We are making this a family-friendly festival. And that's our entire mission and purpose.
And there's a public restroom a block away.
Oh, yeah,
so
absolutely.
You're right there. You don't have to go far to even go to the bathroom.
You don't have to go far.
So
and, you know, we'll make showers available if people want them, you know.
Right.
Crystal Beach is right down the street. So, and you're just literally a block and a half from the venue, and so just walk down the street and you're right at the show. So we're really excited about this year. We put a lot of effort and a lot of hard work into it. The committee has been fantastic.
Oh, wow.
And have really, really brought their game. We had a meeting last Tuesday. It's our last meeting before, well, we're going to maybe squeeze one more in
just
before we actually do the show.
Actually get organized.
And I asked all the committee members, and it went like this. I said, I need to know 2 things. I need to know either I've got this or Houston, we have a problem.
Yeah.
And if it's Houston, we have a problem, then what do we do about that? We fix it right now, because by the time showtime comes,
you don't have time to
everything's
fix it.
Gonna be
no,
in place.
No.
But and everyone
time.
Said, you know what? I got this. And it was like
awesome.
That made me feel great. It's a good crew, really good crew of people.
Well, and they're used to doing this.
Yes,
they're
they
are. In a routine,
yep.
And everybody knows their place.
We've
so
gotten,
that's awesome.
We've gotten our chemistry down, we've gotten our rhythm and our pace, and everybody knows their jobs, and everyone's doing them. So
awesome.
I'm grateful. I'm so grateful. a good bunch of people and a great group of friends. We work well together. So
it's nice when you can work on a project and you can actually delegate something and not worry about it.
That's
it's theirs, they take care of it, they're responsible, and it's wonderful when they get finished.
And they're all volunteers. I get paid as an employee of Visit Madison to do this, but these people are all volunteers. They give willingly of their time, their passion, and their excitement for the festival.
Right.
They are all about it. And so they they just do it because they're passionate about it, because
oh,
they love it.
Oh, that's great.
And every year's new.
I think you do a wonderful job every year.
Thanks a lot.
There's a lot of people that come down here, and it's very organized.
Mm-hmm.
The bands come and go on stage smoothly. It's not a big disruption for them to do that. And it's
essential.
Nice.
Yeah, it's essential. You know, you're on a timetable at a festival.
Yes.
And last year when we had some rain, we shifted a couple people around from the main stage, because the main stage is out in the weather. We took Willie Watson off the main stage and put him over in the River Stage tent, because we had a whole hour of downtime.
Oh, right.
Even though we had a three-hour rain delay on the main stage, at the end of the show, at the end of the night, on Saturday night, we were only 10 minutes behind on our schedule.
Now that's bragging rights there.
That's bragging rights.
That's,
I mean, you think about that.
You have that, you know, kind of thing.
Because we use the River Stage to keep the music going, keep people engaged, keep them here at the festival. There's the folk jammer tent, there's the beer tent, you know, there's lots of tents, you know, and they all have great things happening. So, you know, if a little weather happens, we're allowing people to bring in umbrellas for the first time this year.
Right.
We trust that people will not use them as parasols to keep the sun off and obscure other people's views. But man, if it rains and you're stuck out there, you want an umbrella. And so
yes.
We want to accommodate our patrons in that way.
Right.
We don't want our festival to be felt like we're too strict and too stringent on things.
Especially when you have kids with you. You want to keep them from getting wet. Cold rain.
So. If this is a family festival, then you got to take care of families.
Oh, yeah. You got to do
that.
The bands that you have coming this year, you've got several on Thursday night.
Oh, yeah. We've got, Thursday night is our free warm-up to River Roots show.
Yes.
We've done it the last 2 years up on the hill at the Boneyard, and we want to thank the Groomses in the Boneyard for facilitating
They've been wonderful.
They've been
about
great.
They've
been wonderful with us. But this year, we decided that we really wanted to keep it all within the footprint of the festival.
Make
Thursday night almost like a part of the,
it is part of
it. And so what we did was we moved it down to the River Stage, and we've expanded the River Stage to a larger tent this year because it was so popular. It was packed last year, especially on Saturday. Rain or shine, it was packed.
Right.
And so we decided to make that a bigger stage and use that as our Thursday night, you know, warm up to River Roots free party event, which starts at 7:00. Rusty Bladen, our own Rusty Bladen, will be kicking off the night and the weekend. It's wonderful to have Rusty kick off the whole weekend of River Roots.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, he's a Madisonian, and he's a staple. He's a homeboy, and it's so good to have Rusty on board this year. And then the second band is Appalatin, who has played the festival twice. I couldn't tell you which years. I think it's 13 and 14. We have them together.
And where are they from?
They're from Louisville.
Yes.
It's two guys from Hazard County, Kentucky, and four guys from Central America.
That's right. I remember now.
Yeah.
So
It's a very Latin influenced bluegrass music.
I love it.
It's a neat chemistry.
Liked it the last time I heard them.
Yeah.
And
their energy is really high. We're going to have three food trucks we're going to have that night, and then we're going to bring more food trucks in on Monday.
Right.
Friday.
Yes.
Friday and Saturday. But on Thursday night, we will have good food down here available from several of our caterers. And then we'll also have three of our microbreweries will be here serving. We'll have 9 total different microbreweries night.
Now, which microbreweries are going to be here?
Oh, gosh. I could name a lot of them, but I don't think I could name them all because Don Clapham has done such a good job taking care of it. I don't think too much about who the breweries are. I know we have Tin Smith Brewing Company, and I think we have New Albanian. It's back. They've been with us every year.
Right.
Powerhouse out of Columbus, Indiana.
Right.
I think Upland Brewery is coming back this year. We have seven breweries. If I'm forgetting somebody, I apologize, but there's a lot of stuff.
Right.
A lot of elements, a lot of nuts and bolts.
There's a lot of things to remember, so you can't be expected to remember it all.
Suffice to say, there'll be 7 microbreweries and 21 different beers available on Friday and Saturday. And some of those microbrewers will be down there on Thursday for the free party. So that's Thursday.
Right.
Come down to the River Stage, bring the kids. It goes from 7 till 11 p.m. If you haven't got your wristband by then, you can still save $5.
Yes.
Because on May 1st, they go up, you know, pre-sale's on right now.
Yes.
At $25.
Right.
And on May 1st, it goes up to $30. And it'll still be $30 if you wait until the very last minute at the free party on Thursday night. You can still get a wristband for $30. But on Friday and Saturday, it goes up to $35 at the gate.
Oh.
So, you know, you want to act now. You want to be proactive and think positive about all the good stuff that's going to happen at River Roots and make your plans to come. Yeah. Let's talk about the show. On Friday and Saturday night. Let's talk about the lineup for the festival. It's great to have Rusty and Appalatin, and then the real deal starts to happen at 5:00 on Friday, May 20th. The gates open, and at 5:30 on the main stage, Darling Side, a terrific band of four guys, wonderful, beautiful four-part harmonies, and kind of very fun and little precocious as far as their lyrics go. Really great band. They're going to open the show this year. We're very excited to have them. They're going to also perform on WFPK's live lunch at 12 noon.
Oh, that's awesome.
That afternoon.
Yes.
In Louisville. And it's because WFPK is the sponsor of the festival. And then they're going to come up here and open the show on Friday
right.
night. So that's Darling Side. And then at 6:45, we're bringing up Joan Shelley and Charlene Mize. And I can't remember the other girl's name in the band, but it's three girls from Louisville called Maiden Radio.
Yes.
Beautiful harmonies. Beautiful
right.
harmonies. We really like good vocals in River Roots. They will be playing on the River Stage from 6:45 to 7:45. And then at 7:30 on the main stage is Lindy Ortega. And I was just listening to Lindy today, and she sounds a little like Elin Jewell, who's kind of a country swing singer that we had here in 2010. And she sounds like a really young Dolly Parton.
Oh,
I mean,
my
she's
goodness.
Just got this richness to her voice.
Yeah.
And real sassy,
uh-huh.
sassy, upbeat, kind of a touch of Western swing, a little pedal steel guitar. You know, so it's Western country, but she's got an edge to her. She's a young girl, but I think she's 25 maybe.
So she sings solo, but she has
she's
a band,
full band
with her.
Full band, yeah.
Right.
She is a songwriter, but she's backed by a full band. So
that's
we're
great.
We're real excited about Lindy Ortega.
Yeah.
Then on the other stage, on the River Stage at 8:45, I'm right. really proud of this one because she's a main stage act. She could easily pull off the main stage, and
right.
that is Sarah DeRose.
Yes.
Sarah DeRose is, she's played the Grand Ole Opry, she's played the Ryman Auditorium, she has played on Austin City Limits at least twice. We've been trying to get her for years, but she was in college. She was doing finals during May,
She finally
Yeah, she finally graduated, and she's an amazing singer-songwriter,
right.
a great instrumentalist. She plays mandolin and baritone mandolin and banjo and also guitar, and then she has a cellist and a fiddle player with her.
Oh,
and
wow.
just a three-piece band, but just terrific, terrific energy.
Well, that all goes together, though.
It does, very much. It's just a trio, but it's a big sound. And she could easily be on the main stage because she is a national name act, but the music committee chose to put her on the River Stage as a really intimate opportunity for people to see her up close and personal.
Right.
You know, you're not going to see her like this at the Brown Auditorium.
Oh, no. You're going to be...
Or somewhere like that.
You're going to be so close you can count the hairs on
yeah,
her eyebrows.
Yeah, and she's going to be right there. And
yeah.
so that's our closer on the River Stage. And then on the main yes. stage, we have the Brothers Comatose on Friday night. And if I were to compare them to a band, I would say they're probably similar to maybe the Avett Brothers or Old Crow Medicine Show.
Yes.
Kind of that jug band, string
yes.
band, foot stomping,
yeah.
good upbeat music stuff. Five guys, great voices, good harmonies, and a lot of fun music. So that's our Friday lineup. And then on Saturday...
Oh my, you've got several on Saturday.
yeah.
You're going to be here all day.
Yeah, well, we want you to be here all day. That's what it's all about. Yeah. Where else would you be except down at Bicentennial Park at River
Roots? That's
true. It only happens once a year. So we've got on Saturday, the gates open at 11 a.m. And you can come on in and grab your seat and make yourself comfortable. And then at noon, we have the Youth Sing group that comes down from our junior high school. And they come down and perform classic Americana tunes, classic American
oh,
tunes.
Oh,
you know.
Wow.
Yeah. And so
I'm sure they've been practicing.
Yeah, patriotic
long.
Songs and all kinds of older folk songs, Stephen
right.
Foster and that kind of things. And they perform for about a half an hour until 12:30. So we really encourage people to come down early and support the kids and show up. And then at 1 o'clock, the music actually starts on the main stage.
Right.
And this year we have from Louisville an all-female group called Bridge 19. They have a new album out, new CD. Four very talented girls, good harmonies, cool, very progressive sound to their music. I really like them very much. And so we're thrilled to have them. That's our opening act on Saturday. And then at 1:45, we have on the River Stage, we have a guy named Jake Book from Cincinnati area, Northern Kentucky. And I think he actually lives out in Missouri now. I think he just recently moved. But Jake's coming back to this area, and he's played Madison before. He's an old-timey player, clawhammer,
yes,
banjo,
I've heard
and
him.
Fiddle, and he stomps, and he sings these great old Appalachian tunes,
right.
early folk tunes and early country tunes. He's a solo act, really good energy, and so he'll be doing the first set on the River Stage, and that's at 1:45. On the main stage at, let's see, it'll be 2:30, I guess it would be, is Blair Crimmins and the Hookers. So for those of you that came and saw St. Paul and the Broken Bones,
yes.
I think it was 2013, that high energy energy with the horn section and the whole thing. That's kind of what these guys do. It's a bluesy, jazzy, big band kind of sound. Oh. And we always like to stick a band like that in that 2:30, 3 o'clock slot in the early afternoon. Gets everybody pumped up.
It wakes everybody up a little bit.
Yep, and gets everybody all fired up. So Blair Crewman's and the Hookers, great band. So that's right after Bridge 19. Then on the River Stage, after Jake Book, we have Jamie Stone's Lomax Project. And Jamie Stone is a young man who plays banjo and guitar and has done a lot of research about Alan Lomax, who was an historian, a musical historian, back in the early 20th century that went into Appalachia and found all these mountain tunes and all these people that lived in the hollers.
So he's bringing those with him.
He brought all that music out. Jamie Stone is doing a kind of a tribute, but it's more of an educational performance of the music that Alan Lomax discovered in Appalachia and brought, and it's what eventually led to country music.
Right.
You know, in the early 20th century, Maybelle Carter and A.P. Carter, you know, the Carter family.
I remember.
They got that music from Alan Lomax, and they developed it into country, and they made it their own. So Jamie's doing a great job. He's also doing a workshop in the Folk Jammers tent at 4:30 in the afternoon.
The
workshop's going to be just a little more education than it is the performance. The performance on the stage is going to be more of a performance of the songs,
right.
And then he'll be giving more historical background in the workshop.
A lot of kids need to come and see that, even adults.
Children of all ages. This is an opportunity to learn.
That's something to help you understand the music.
I homeschool. My wife and I homeschool our son, and these are educational opportunities for kids outside of the box.
Oh, goodness.
So this is part of River Roots' mission and purpose, and also the Ohio River Valley Folk Society, our nonprofit, is to focus on education and culture in our public schools and in our community. So it's not just about putting on a music show. It's so much more than that. So Jamie's going to be, he's that element at the festival for us this year.
That's going to be that's a rich part of the festival.
It is a huge part. So back to the main stage at 5 o'clock, or actually I think it's 4 o'clock, we have Billy Strings. He's a former punk rocker who took up the bluegrass guitar and put down the electric guitar and decided he really liked it, and he plays really fast. He's an amazing player. He's a young guy. He's going to have a full band, I think a four-piece band, and he'll be doing some high-octane bluegrass music.
Oh, my.
It's really
That'll definitely wake everybody up.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. And so, after Billy plays, we've got over on the River Stage again, we've got Marty O'Reilly and the Old Soul Orchestra.
Right.
Marty's got a really unique voice. They're from Portland, Oregon, and really interesting songs, a little gypsy jazz flavor to them, kind of a lilting jazz feel to it. The fiddle player is fantastic, reminds me a lot of Stefan Grappelli or some of that gypsy, you know, Hot Club of France jazz kind of feel to it. So Marty's very cool. And then we go back to the main stage for Parker Millsap.
Right.
And Parker Millsap is an up-and-coming songwriter, much like John Fulbright was. Folks, remember John Fulbright from last year? He was a huge hit at the 5 o'clock slot, and that's where we put Parker. Very similar, strong singer, songwriter, really good lyrics, good songwriting, and a good band behind him. So that's on the main stage, and then we go back for the final act on the River Stage, and that will be the John Stickley Trio. Now, John is an amazing guitar player, much like Billy Strings, and he has a trio with a fiddle player and an upright bass player, and it's all instrumental music, though, so it's really an hour of high-octane, good. I love you saying that word, high octane. Those two words.
But that describes
high
the
energy
festival.
Music. It's high energy, yeah.
The whole day will be like that.
Yeah, and it's not all blah, 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 blah. It's just high energy and happy and good feelings and great music and good vibes. So John Stickley is going to be on the River Stage to close out that stage at 6:45.
Right.
At 5:30, he and Billy Strings are going to be in the Folk Jammer tent doing a guitar workshop, a bluegrass guitar workshop. So if you want to come.
More education.
Bring your six-string guitar and come to the Folk Jammer tent and learn some hot new licks from some of the best guitar players around right now, some of the best young guys that are coming up. And they'll be paired up together, which is awesome. And at the end of the night, after our headliner, I'll get to the headliner here in a minute, we'll be doing an after party, much like the warm-up party, but we're going to do it up at Red Bicycle Hall. It'll be about 11:30 at night on Main Street at 125 East Main. And the John Stickley Band and Billy Strings Band will be on the stage together, both bands jamming it out. So that's going to be a hoot, and that's going to be how we're going to wrap up the festival. But before we do that, we've got two more great bands coming. We've got Donna the Buffalo, who we've been very interested in for quite some time. Two bands that have been around for a long time.
Now, you've tried a long time to get her, haven't you?
Yes, we have.
Yes.
we've been very interested in her for a while, and we were finally able to close the deal this year.
Oh, wow.
And Donna the Buffalo, I mean, they have a female singer, but she's not Donna. It's just the name of the band, but it's a good-sized band and good harmonies and a cult following, a very strong following of fans that have been,
right,
you know, keeping up with them for years. So we got them, and then they're going to warm up the, you know, the final closing act, which is Asleep at the Wheel.
Oh.
If you like Texas Swing, if you like Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys, and you like a good cowboy hat and pair of cowboy boots, and
right,
you like to boot scoot boogie the two-step, this is your band.
Oh, wow.
Asleep at the Wheel is an American iconic band. They've been around for 40 years. They are literally carrying the torch of Western swing music, which is just wonderful music. If you like dancing songs like Route 66, that kind of thing, it's fantastic. You've got fiddle players, you've got a pedal steel player. It's a big band of 8 people, and they just come off roaring off the stage. And they're being inducted as the inaugural inductees into the Austin City Limits Hall of Fame.
Oh, my goodness. That's amazing.
That's a new Hall of Fame down in Austin, Texas.
Yes.
For the show.
That's a great honor for those guys.
It's a great honor, and they've been a, you know, an anchor for that show,
yes,
for years. So they just created the Hall of Fame this year, and they are the first inductees.
Oh.
And so, you know, they deserve it after 40 years, my gosh.
Oh, my goodness.
So,
well, that just shows how much work they put into all that.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, they have really worked hard.
They have, and they're a great band. And we've got a lot of diversity, I think, you know, in the music.
Right.
It's folk-based, it's root-based, it's string-based, but still, there's a little bit of rock and roll in there, there's a little bit of horns, there's, you know, a little bit of everything.
Oh, so starting May the 19th on a Thursday.
Right.
Until
be the free party.
May the 20th, mm-hmm, 21st. Is the whole weekend. So you get Thursday, Friday,
right,
and Saturday night. And of course, when you go up to Bicycle Hall on Saturday night after you're finished at 11 o'clock, you all may not go home until daylight. So
we try to shut it down about 1:30 or so. But
well, somewhere
by then
in there,
everybody's really tired. But it's just,
yeah,
a great way to blow off the final steam and,
yes,
go, wow, what a,
yes,
weekend. What a great time.
Yes.
And so we've really enjoyed putting on the after party. So there's a ton of great stuff happening at River Roots this year. And all we've talked about so far as a band, we've been talking for a good 20 minutes,
yeah,
or so.
But you know,
no, we've talked about
the
music.
The real important
so much
thing
more
is the two bands that are going to be teaching kids, either or adults, anybody, mm-hmm, either how to play or the history of the mm-hmm, bluegrass music. And that, I think, is just so important. If a lot of schools would, mm-hmm, send the kids out here, or the homeschool,
yep,
kids come out, that is a lot of history and richness that they can,
mm-hmm,
get. One-on-one education is much easier to absorb,
yes,
than to learn it in a classroom.
Right, and it's much faster.
Yes.
And so, and these people that are putting these workshops on are young people.
Yeah.
I mean, they're all under 25 or right around, you know, mid-20s.
So they can actually relate,
yeah,
to the,
yeah,
kids or even adults, because,
yeah,
they're right in the middle.
Yeah.
And they can help a lot.
It's been remarkable, and we're trying to show this in the festival too, about the passing of the torch from older generation,
more
established
important
bands like Asleep,
yes,
at the Wheel, to bands like Lindy Ortega and Brothers Comatose. I mean, they're,
right,
passing the torch, and know that these guys are passing it down to our kids,
yes,
and keeping this music alive and keeping it fresh. It's
That's only important.
You know, the thing about the roots music now and Americana music is that it's really fresh and it's cutting edge.
Right.
And it's because young people are showing up and becoming enchanted with it and enamored with it, but doing their own thing with it.
Right.
So that's what's really, really exciting.
Now, you have other things that we need to talk about,
we
too,
do,
don't you?
We do. I could talk,
yeah,
about bands all night, but there's a ton of stuff about River Roots.
Oh, my goodness. I don't know how you can do everything, to be honest. There's so much going on.
You can do a little bit of everything, but you can't do everything.
No. Well,
it's
you
just
can,
the way
well,
it is. It,
you couldn't really be enriched by it if,
yeah,
you did everything.
Right.
So
right,
you have to kind of pick and choose what you want to do during,
yeah,
the festival.
Yeah, you're going to find something that's just going to make you want to sit down and spend the whole hour just listening,
yes,
to this one thing, because,
well,
it's like it really resonates.
I think that's going to be pretty often. So.
Yeah. Yeah, I know.
So what else do we have to tell everybody about this festival?
You know, the festival is a family-friendly event. I touched on the folk jammer tent where we do the workshops. So I think the next thing I want to talk about is the Folk Art Village.
Yes.
And I want to thank Arvin Sango, who is our marquee sponsor for the Folk Art Village. For the first time this year, they've come on board and have supported it financially and really made us able to,
yes,
grow it and succeed. So we have the Folk Jammer Tent, which is a tent where you can go and jam with people. If you have a musical instrument and you play, bring your guitar or your banjo or whatever to the festival and go in that tent, sit and pick with people, get to know some folks you've never played with.
That's another opportunity to learn.
It is another opportunity to learn.
You know,
share songs.
It, yeah,
goes around and around. And that's happening whenever we're not doing workshops. But The other things we're doing in the Folk Jammer tent is we have a percussion ensemble this year. Actually, I'm going to back up just a little bit. On Friday,
yes,
the Ohio River Valley Folk Society, our nonprofit, in coordination with Riverroots, is doing programming in the public schools.
Right.
So we're bringing in Daryl House and Clang, this percussion ensemble, to come and perform and do an interactive performance with our students at E.O. Muncie, and also I think we're going to do it up at Rikers Ridge. So Clang is coming in and Daryl too. So it's going to be a lot of fun. It's going to be a lot of percussion and learning how to play rhythms and how to play together. So they're going to do that on Friday, but then they're going to also come to the festival on Saturday, and at 2:00, as soon as Bridge 19 finishes, the first band on stage, we're going to assemble everyone on the concrete pad in front of the stage, and we're going to hand them percussion instruments, as many as we have, and we're going to have a parade through the festival grounds over to the Folk Jammer tent,
yeah,
where at 2:30, Clang is going to give another percussion workshop where people can play and you know, learn rhythmic patterns,
yes,
and have a drum circle and things like that. So we're going to have a parade with a stilt walker.
Wow.
We're even going to have a stilt walker. So Clang's doing that at the Folk Jammer tent, and then we also have the Jamie Stone Lomax Project, which I mentioned, and also John Stickley Trio.
Yes.
And there's a few other workshops that will be happening. And all this information is available on the website, folks, at riverroots.org, www.riverroots.org.
Right.
You can find all this stuff out there, or also liking our Facebook page.
Yes.
Riverroots has a Facebook page, Riverroots Music and Folk Arts Festival.
And if you like the Facebook page, it'll remind you every so often when they make a post that Riverroots is coming up. So.
Yeah, we've got a lot of content going up on the page right now, so there's a lot of cool things that you can keep track of, and you can follow the festival leading up to it and get really a lot of inside information. So we've got that, the Folk Jammer tent. We have the Folk Art Village, where we have artistic demonstrators showing how to do glass blowing, lathe turning, loom weaving, a variety of contemporary folk arts. And then we also have an interactive area for kids where they'll be able to, there'll be like six stations, I think, where they'll be able to do a variety of different arts and crafts and create art. And we'll provide the supplies. And we're also going to have the giant sandbox, which we're doubling in size this year.
That's what you said. You're going to double the sandbox.
Yeah,
it's going to be huge.
It's going to be huge. It was a big hit in the last 2 years. And so we got permission from the city to go ahead and double it up this year and make it twice as big. So kids will be able to mold in the sand. We're going to have this guy that does Pat Gorley, he does these big bubbles.
Oh, yes.
The bubble guy.
Big enough for you to stand
Pat Gorley will be out there this year for the kids. So that's all in the Folk Art Village. And then we also have our historic demonstrators over by the River Stage, which are part of the Folk Art Village concept, but they're not in the same footprint.
Right.
They're over by the River Stage. And Walt DeBell puts it together with, they're all period demonstrators in period costume. And they are demonstrating period crafts such as rope making, blacksmithing, things like that.
Oh,
so there's another educational opportunity for people to learn about crafts that are 100 to 200, 150 to 200 years old, and how things were done back before the age of the industrial age of the
1870s. I like the educational side of it.
It's pretty cool.
But then you can listen to the music while you're doing all that.
You can
at the
do
same
all
time.
That. So that's the Folk Art Village. It's a big deal, and thanks again to Arvind Sango for providing sponsorship for that.
They do a great job.
They do so many good things for the community.
They do.
As many of our corporations do. And
yes.
I'm going to thank all of our sponsors at the end, because we have a ton of them.
You know,
they all step up and do a great job.
I think Madison is very fortunate in the way that the business owners here and the corporations support the different things that are offered.
Sure.
I don't know of any other place that has that much participation.
I'm from Indianapolis, a town of 1 million people.
Yes.
And it's not like that there.
I don't think it's
much harder to do this kind of thing there. People really work together and know each other here. And, and so because you know each other, you have personal relationships that help make things happen.
It does.
And people are much more anonymous in a large town of, you know, a million people. It's really hard to connect.
Make the connections. There's no emotional attachment there.
Right, right.
Not like here.
And you can't make the connections. You're cold calling people and things. So it's a totally different dynamic. Totally different dynamic.
But, I think our region between Crestwood, Kentucky, and North Vernon and Versailles, that we're really close knit here because we travel between the cities here and go to the festivals. And
we're still 100 miles from Indianapolis, 50 some miles from Louisville, 70 miles from Cincinnati. Madison is a really wonderful location.
I had somebody tell me today, and I thought this was a really neat way to describe us, because we are between Indianapolis, Cincinnati, and Louisville, we're the Golden Triangle. I like that.
I like the Golden Triangle.
I like the Golden Triangle.
It's better than the Bermuda Triangle.
Oh, no, we're not the Bermuda.
We're not the Bermuda Triangle.
No, we're the Golden Triangle.
No, there's
enough. We live in the Golden Triangle.
Yeah, there's enough ghost phenomenon down here without having to...
And we
aggravate it. We don't need to aggravate it.
No.
So so that's the Folk Art Village.
Yes.
You know, and we've got face painting and a lot of other cool things for the kids.
Uh-huh.
And then we have the craft beer tent. You know, it's as I mentioned earlier, it's National Craft Brew Week, the week of River Roots,
right,
every year. So
now what happens in that tent?
Beer.
Well, I mean,
and wine.
If it's the brewer tent, are mm-hmm. they teaching you how to make beer in the tent?
No, we're not actually doing a seminar, but we're teaching you about tasting and understanding the palate of handcrafted beers.
The different...
Right, as opposed to...
The different ingredients make it either have a more of a bite or a darker color,
right,
or...
As opposed to your mass-produced market beers. And I'm not going to name names, but the festival is about handcrafted art. It's about handcrafted food.
Right.
You know, good quality food, food trucks. It's about handcrafted beers. It's about handmade music. It's all about things that are handmade.
Yes.
You know, it's folk art. And beer has been around for generations upon generations. Since the Trappist monks and probably the Ethiopians, I'm thinking.
Well, you can change the flavor just by adding a little more hops or a little more brown sugar.
Yeah. A lot of subtleties, and people that really like to develop that palate, which I do very much, I love craft beer, are going to really enjoy the craft brew tent. We've got 7 microbreweries, as I mentioned earlier.
Yes.
21 different beers.
Oh my goodness.
On Friday and Saturday. And then we're also doing there's a beer judging contest, so it's a little too late to enter the contest this year.
Right.
But we do this every year, have a beer making contest, and it's usually a specific kind of beer that everyone makes a version of, and then we have a judging, and it's all sanctioned by the Indiana Brewers Guild, who is also a sponsor of our craft brew tent this year. So
that makes the
official
award a little
special. It's kind of like the way Riverfest does the nationally sanctioned barbecue competition, but not as big, not as nearly as big.
Right.
But we're working on that. So we've got craft beer, we've got folk art, we've got family activities, we've got food trucks. We're bringing in some great food this year, including the taco truck from up on the hill.
Oh, you know,
at the resource center.
Everybody
loves
that taco truck.
Have you eaten there?
Well, I've eaten there twice.
Oh, I love
That's it.
That's it. I love it.
You know, you get more food.
Yeah.
You think you're buying a taco and it's going to be like about this big, and all of a sudden you get this taco that'll feed you for 4 days.
And really, really reasonably priced. You know, Sidal and Jasmine have brought a wonderful thing to this community, and we've tried the past 2 years to get them to come down, but they were just trying to get their legs under them and get their business going.
They
and this year they said, we're coming.
Oh,
we're going to play. We're going to be at River. So that's going to be great. There's going to be a lot of great food in the food court, which is right across from the River Stage. So you can move around freely. There's chairs at the River Stage, folks. I want to tell you this. You don't have to move your camp chairs. When you put your camp chair up at the main stage, you can leave it there and just walk over to the River Stage. We're going to have probably 200 chairs there at least, and you can catch music over there, but not have to give up your spot.
Right. Now, can people bring their own chairs when they come?
Yes, you can bring your own camp chairs. Absolutely. You can bring umbrellas. That's a good thing. Let's talk about the things you can and can't bring.
Cannot bring. That's a very good idea.
Bring a smile.
Oh, definitely.
Bring a good attitude. Bring sunscreen and wear a sun hat.
Yes.
Bring an umbrella in case there is rain, but don't use it unless there is rain. Bring an empty water bottle, because Joe Boone and Boonies is providing a water station. We've done this the last 2 years. So you'll have fresh filtered water, free water, at the water station, which is going to be just to the west of the, or to the east of the stage, so it'll be right there.
Yes.
We have the VIP tent this year, which is pretty cool too, but anyway, I'm getting off track here.
What can they not bring?
They cannot bring firearms, pets of any sort, attitudes.
Oh, definitely. Leave those at home.
No alcohol, no coolers, no weapons of any sort.
Right.
Just use common sense. And remember, this is a family-oriented show.
This
is a family-friendly show. And we really mean that sincerely. And we have great security, but we don't want people to have to feel like they're, on edge all the time.
Right.
You know, we want people to be relaxed, and our security officers know what they're doing. They're very professional. But we want everyone to just have a relaxed, comfortable scene. So make good choices. Use your head when you come to a festival like this, and leave unnecessary things behind.
Yeah.
Don't bring drugs, and don't bring,
Yeah. And, but make sure you remember that water bottle. Boonies is providing the water.
And hopefully sunscreen.
Day.
You're going to need some sunscreen.
yes, if you're going to
I'm hoping we're going to need some sunscreen this year, huh? You know? We're good for it. So, but those are the things that we basically, that we want people to think about when they come to the festival. What you can do, what we'd rather you not do.
Right. So. Now, again, if they are going to bring a tent, there's only 4 people to a tent. That's to each spot.
To $10 per person per night.
And they get it, how big is the area that they get?
It's about 20 by 20 feet.
20 by 20.
Yeah.
So we don't want somebody to bring a tent that's like 40 by 40.
No, they're all squared off spaces.
Yes.
And you can order your campsite right online at riverroots.org.
Right.
Tongue tied.
And then they're marked off when you get here. They're numbered, so you know where you're going to be.
You know where you're going to be. And they'll assign you a site when you get here.
Yes.
I want to thank Dan Williams and the guys from Whispering Beard Festival who manage our campsite every year. They come over for Friendship. We've developed a sisterhood bond with that festival that happens in August. So they come and help us out. We go over there and we help them out for their festival and we support each other. So they do a great job of managing the park here and Fireman's Park and the screen space in cooperation with the city. So
you can't do an event by yourself. You have to
No.
We were talking about that the other day. You know, we were talking about how businesses, if they actually get together to accomplish something, they accomplish more and it's easier.
That's
and
right.
You know, you're more successful.
Right.
But you see businesses that try to do things by themselves and they don't survive.
A rising tide lifts all boats, you know.
Yes. Yeah. So you need to partner with people and make things happen.
Yes, it's a collaborative effort.
Yes, it
absolutely is.
Yeah.
And a symbiotic relationship within the community.
Right.
So, and then, you know, River Roots has expanded too. We're doing the River Roots music series now year round. So River Roots is as I've said for the past 3 or 4 years, it's a state of mind. It's a year-round state of mind in Madison.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
not just an event. It's not just a festival.
You know, and everybody talks about it through the whole year.
They do.
And, you know, wonder, well, now who's going to be here this year?
Yeah,
and they start asking 2 or 3 months after you're done with this one, they'll start asking who's going to be at the next one, even though you don't know yet.
We try to get it figured out by December 31st, and we always do our lineup announcement in January. And that way people have a lot of time to get excited, and then the tickets go on sale on March 1st.
Right.
Boom. Which I want to say again, tickets right now are on sale at the pre-sale price.
$25.
Only $25. And you can go online to riverroots.org and buy your tickets. You can buy your VIP tent pass, which I mentioned earlier. VIP tents passes are only $150. There's only 100 tickets, and you have a covered stage with a fenced prime seating, prime viewing area seated by the stage. You get all your beverages, your beer, wine, and food all weekend provided. And it's $150, and there's only 100 tickets, as I said. So you can order all these things online on our ticket page at riverroots.org. So we try to make it easy for people to, you know, make their plans. And we've revamped the website this year, so you need to check out the website.
It's much
more user friendly.
Yes.
Absolutely. So that's it. This is River Roots in a nutshell.
Oh my goodness.
But I do want to say one more little thing before we close here, and that is, I want to talk about our sponsors.
Yes, we need to thank the people that sponsor this, because
I've got this sheet of paper down here.
They really go out of their way to take care of the River Roots.
They do.
And they do so much in the community. They don't just sponsor this, they sponsor a lot of other things. And when we talk about these festivals, we don't always mention the sponsors, and I think that's important, because
it's hugely important.
Without their support, these things couldn't happen.
They wouldn't happen.
They would not happen.
So we created the Ohio River Valley Folk Society, our nonprofit organization, 4 years ago, as a fundraising mechanism for River Roots to raise money through sponsorships, and also through our friends of River Roots, our membership organization.
Right.
You know, donations. So people that want to be a contributor to River Roots and want to give something, you don't have to be a $1,500 to $15,000 sponsor. If you do a membership, you can be an individual or a small business and do a membership from anywhere from $100 to $1,000. And there's a variety of different levels. You can find out about this all at the riverroots.org website. Become a member or support. Click on the Support the Festival tab.
Right.
And you'll see how to be a sponsor or a member and all the different perks that you can get at the different sponsorship levels.
Right.
So,
but you can be on the banners.
Absolutely.
As of now. You can't be on the poster.
Well, yeah. A lot of the printed materials is too late for sponsorships.
The print stuff is done.
But members are still able to get recognition right up to the day of the festival.
Your banners and anything we do, if we do another story like this later on, you'd be on that one also. Mm-hmm. We'd make sure that you're there.
And once you're, you know, at this point, if you become a member, you're a member through the 2017 festival.
Right.
You know, we're so close to the festival now that if you become a member during the month of May, you're going to be a festival member for the next year.
Right.
Which gets you into all of the River Roots music series performances at Red Bicycle Hall, gets you into the halfway event and the kickoff event. So it gets you some good perks.
Oh, I think so.
And and you also get the good feeling that you're supporting something of real value in our community. So I want to thank all of our members that have currently joined and become and renewed their memberships, or if you're considering becoming a member of the Folk Society, you can do so, as I said, on the website at riverroots.org.
Keep in mind the educational part of this. You know, if your kids are homeschooled, and you know, if you want to help give your kids a rich base of all of the music that happens here, this would be a good thing to support because it's like a classroom when you come.
It is.
So it's awesome, you know.
It is very much so. Anyway, our sponsors.
Yes, name them off.
Morgan Foods. I want to thank Morgan Foods for coming back on board as our marquee sponsor for the entire festival, our title sponsor. They do a terrific job for us every year. I thank John Morgan very much and all the staff at Morgan Foods. Grody Industries. Thanks to Grody for coming back on this year. They always do a corporate party up in the tents on the hill. We have a good working relationship, and they throw a party for their employees.
They do.
Up at Rivers. They chose our venue to do that.
So I really appreciate it. That's their thank you to their employees.
Arvin Sango for being the title sponsor for our Folk Art Village. I also want to thank Grody Industries is also our title sponsor for the main stage.
Oh, yes.
So we have them. Oxtra family. I want to thank the Oxtra family and Craig Toyota. This year is the last year that Clint Bear will be donating a handmade guitar for us to give away. This is the 10th anniversary, and we have a special 10th anniversary model that he has made for this celebration. And then this is the last one we're going to give away this year. We've done it for our members and our sponsors and people that, you know, I own a Clint Bear guitar. I'm going to try and get a raffle ticket. I don't know about everybody else. But if you become a member, you get a 50% discount on a raffle ticket to win this guitar. There's only 100 tickets that are going to be in the drawing. And so that's a really cool opportunity. And we also give away a painting from Gigi Straub this year and signed guitar from Crawdaddy Music, signed by all the artists. We get them to sign it backstage, and we give that away too. So the raffle is all part of this membership and sponsorship program that you can take advantage of. So anyway, yeah, those are our top five sponsors. I want to thank OC Bear, Clint Bear, MPS Printing. Jeff Dagger always does a great job for us in printing our posters and our banners and everything. German American Bank has just taken over River Valley Financial Bank, and so we'd like to welcome them to the community, and I appreciate their sponsorship on behalf of River Valley Financial Bank, who has been a sponsor of the festival for many years. I'm appreciative that German American sees the value of community relations and community outreach as they come in and introduce themselves to the community. That's very important, and I'm really happy about that. I want to thank BJ and Mark and the Gray family up at Cruisin' Auto. They were our title sponsor when this festival first started. They were our number one sponsor, and they stuck with us all these years and are still sponsoring the festival. So very appreciative of them. Historic Madison Incorporated, Madison Precision, Rivertown Chiropractic, Thornton Terrace, Vehicle Services Group, Steinhardt Heating and Cooling, Madison Chemical. All of these people have been, you know, supporters of the festival for years. Madison Chemical came on for the first time 2 years ago, but they were still with us. Jenner Hensley Patterson and Wynn, the Madison Apothecary.
Yes.
Royer Corporation came on this year for the first time, so I'd like to thank Roger Williams personally, and Roger was just been terrific and very supportive and sees the value of this. We have IKE, the power plant, has come back on board as a sponsor after being absent for 2 years, so they're back with us. So thanks to Cliff Carnes and everyone there. Alcorn Sage, Schwartz and McGrath is a new sponsor of the law firm with Meredith Alcorn and his group. So I appreciate them very much. And also Charlotte Ballard at the Lighthouse has come on board as a sponsor for the first time this year as well. We have a good partnership working with them and trying to accommodate their patrons, and we try and work together
while the festival. And they're right in the footprint.
They're right
of the
there.
Festival.
So, you know, they enjoy some overflow. People love to go down to the Lighthouse and enjoy the riverfront and, you know, feed the catfish french fries. And then we have the Indiana Brewers Guild, who's our sponsor of our craft brew tent. And we want to thank the Leo Weekly, music and entertainment weekly down out of Louisville, and also Nouveau, the entertainment weekly out of my hometown of Indianapolis.
Right.
And WFYI, public television and public radio in Indianapolis. WNKU, public television, or public radio rather, out of Cincinnati, and WFBK in Louisville. And finally, I want to thank the Madison Courier for everything that they do for us, and also the Roundabout Magazine. Don Ward does a great job supporting us. And the Holiday Inn Express and the Riverboat Inn. And also the Comfort Inn this year. We have to putting up our musicians and everything.
Right.
So there's a lot of people that are engaged, like you said, as partnerships.
It is.
That make this whole thing come on. And so we do this every year, you know, and we all work together and we make it happen for River Roots and for Madison. So
that, well, I think, you know, with this kind of a festival, it's not just for Madison, it's the region again.
Oh,
we got our Golden Triangle there.
Yeah, and even more so. We have people come from Minnesota,
oh,
Chicago.
My goodness, yeah. There's people that take their
North
vacations
Carolina
and come down for this.
To come down for River Roots.
You know, they'll stay all weekend. A lot of them come in like on a Tuesday or Wednesday and they stay till Monday and then drive back.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's a huge event.
Yeah, you can't start camping until Friday night though.
That's true.
So if you come down to the
Come
down for the free party, don't plan on camping in Fireman's Park until Friday morning.
Oh, right.
So the free party is really more for our local friends, our fellow Madisonians.
Yes. Yes.
And a thank you to them and for them to come down and appreciate. Let us show our appreciation for them and for the community.
And then there's another thing that we need to remember when you're at this festival. All the festivals here in Madison, there's parking everywhere, but there are places that people park their cars because they live there. So you have to be courteous of that and just remember that if there's a chair sitting there, that's usually because the 84-year-old lady that lives there would like to park in front of her house. So
it's
please
true.
Don't move the chairs.
or the trash cans.
Or whatever
other barricades people put up. But you're right. Parking can be challenging downtown. And people do live in this community downtown, and they put up with, they're very patient and tolerant.
Oh, they are. They are
supportive.
So wonderful about it.
But they also live here, and so we do work hard to accommodate them and take their concerns into consideration.
And even if you have to park a few blocks away, the town is gorgeous. So
it's
if you have to walk
weekend.
A couple of blocks, it's just wonderful. You'll enjoy
right.
it. You'll enjoy the history of everything.
Yeah, and a walk along the river is always a good thing.
Oh, it is.
That's
it
absolutely true.
Now, we need to reiterate about the phone number and the website, so we make sure people get that towards the end here.
The phone number is 800-559-2956. That's the Visitor Center toll-free line. And you can call them for any information or if you want to order your tickets by phone. But everything else you can do online at riverroots.org.
Right.
That's our website. It's user-friendly. You can find all the information you want. And then if you're really interested in deeper content and more detailed information, go and like us on Facebook. We have over 3,500 friends on Facebook now for River Roots, and it's growing every day.
And they can go back through, and you can go see what they've done in the years past.
Mm-hmm.
And that's always neat, is to click on the first post they did and then go back and look through.
That's true. And we have a video on the website at riverroots.org. We have a video that we put together for the lineup announcement party to announce the bands. And you can watch that. If you haven't seen it, you can watch it. And it's about 10 minutes long, but it shows just about 15-second clips of each band, so you can get a feel for what you're coming to see and who these acts are. We've taken them all from YouTube and assembled them into a nice montage.
I think that's great because that does give them a taste of it. And it makes them understand a little more about what they're going to get to see.
Absolutely.
And learn.
Yeah.
I really think the learning part, I love that part.
it's a big part of what we do.
Yeah. You know, I know kids that go, there's a band that plays in LaGrange at the LaGrange Coffee Roasters.
Mm-hmm.
And on Monday nights, they let anybody come in and play.
Mm-hmm.
And then they all mentor each other.
Oh, that's cool.
And those kids learn more from that session than they do in 6 months of education.
Yeah. It's sharing knowledge and sharing ideas. And
it's that camaraderie there, the personal touch of one-on-one. And you get all these people that pick up on something you need to do a little different, to tweak something.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just great, I think, to actually come in and sit down with musicians in a comfortable setting and enjoy learning.
That's where the Folk Jammer tent is so important. And we're actually enlarged that tent this year, too, from a 20 by 40 to a 30 by 60 foot tent.
Oh, my goodness.
In the River Stage, we went from 30 by 60 to a 30 by 80 foot tent. So, it's just people are coming. They're showing up.
Oh, that's
so
great.
We got to have places for them to enjoy everything. So
that's great. Now, do we have anything else? Are we good?
I think we're good. I want to thank you for inviting me to be a part of this today and
be
on your show. And looking forward to seeing it on Channel 15, right?
Well, it'll be on Channel 15. It's on KentuckianaNews.com.
KentuckianaNews.com. So it'll be online. You can watch it streaming.
Yes, it will be. It'll be on Facebook and Twitter.
Oh, cool. Cool.
So we'll have you out there. And
awesome.
You'll be in the Golden Triangles.
I love the Golden Triangle.
I do. Somebody said that today, and I've latched onto that one. I like that.
That's very good. We're going to have to use that for
us.
I'll have to tell the people in the Arts Alliance to use that for a marketing tool.
That is our area.
But thanks. This is the Voices of Kentuckiana.
It is.
Television show, and I want to thank you, Debbie, for having me
today. Oh, you're welcome. We're really grateful that you took time to talk with us and tell us all the interesting things that are going to be happening.
Right.
So.
Well, we'll see you there.
Well, you will see me there.
I know I'll see you there. And you too.
Please be there. So, well, you guys are going to have to make it out to this. At least go online and check it out. Keep an open mind. See if you can bring the kids to learn something. and have a good time on the weekend.
Bring your cowboy boots or cowgirl boots for Saturday night.
Oh, yes. I forgot about that, didn't I?
That's it.
Yeah, make sure you bring those boots.
All right.
So, thanks so much for watching.
Thank you.